changed and flowed from shape to shape. First as a raven, on whose ancient wings scarcely a feather lingered. Then you seemed a weasel, moving on from stone to stone. And now, at last, you are a human shape, a thin, gray man, half lost in gathering night.
What would you, king of the proud red branch kings?
This will I say, most wise of living souls. Young, subtle Conchobar sat close by me when I gave judgment, and his words were wise. And what to me seemed burden without end, to him seemed easy. So I laid the crown upon his head to cast away my care.
What would you, king of the proud red branch kings?
I feast amid my people on the hill, and pace the woods, and drive my chariot wheels in the white border of the murmuring sea, and still I feel the crown upon my head.
What would you?
I would be no more a king! But know the dreaming wisdom that is yours.
Look on my thin gray hair and hollow cheeks, and on these hands that cannot lift a sword, and on this body that trembles like a wind-blown reed. No woman loves me. No man seeks my help. Because I be not of the
laborer as a king, to do and do and do, and never dream